get it out of my head. Cubase AI and LE comes packaged with a number of different products. So for instance, you might have got it with a Steinberg UR22 Mark II audio interface, or a Yamaha guitar amp, or even a Yamaha keyboard. We're going to connect these devices, go into settings, show you how to set them up, and get making music straight away. Let's go take a look. So I won't stop. The very first thing we need to do is make sure our connections are all set up. I'm using studio monitors, so I'm connecting these leads to the output of my audio device and I'm plugging them into the input of my monitors and turning them on. I'm plugging the USB lead from the computer into the input on the device and making sure the power is set up correctly. Some devices will have their own power supply, so make sure that's plugged in and turned on. Read the manual or watch some videos on how to set up your audio device. MIDI devices are the same. They'll either require a MIDI cable or a USB lead. Some MIDI devices will work straight away when you plug them in. Others will require you to go to the manufacturer's website and download a driver, which will make sure that your device will work with your computer and with Cubase. Next step, it's time to start Cubase. And as you start it, you'll be prompted to select an audio interface. I'm using the Steinberg UR22 Mark II, so I'm selecting that. Now when Cubase loads up, our audio device is already connected. You can change your audio device and your settings by going to Studio and Studio Setup. You could have a number of different devices installed for different applications, and they should all show up in the VST audio system menu. So select the device that you want to use. Every time you switch a device, it'll prompt you to ask you if you're sure. We'll use the THR10C later in the video series, but for now I'm going back to the Steinberg UR22 Mark II. As soon as I select it, you'll notice it appears below the VST audio system. I'm leaving all my ports set to default because this is a very simple, easy to use interface. But what is important is going to the control panel and making sure my buffer size is set correctly. Now, the lower the buffer size, the less latency you'll have, meaning the less time delay you'll hear between what you're actually recording and what you're hearing. A low latency is great for recording. Somewhere around 128 is acceptable. As you add more tracks, instruments, and effects, it'll put a higher strain on your system. So for mixing, we tend to have a higher buffer size. Let's go and take a look at MIDI. In the MIDI port setup, you can see all of the MIDI devices that you have connected to Cubase. If your MIDI device isn't showing up there, that's a red flag. Go back and make sure you've installed the MIDI drivers correctly. As with the audio setup, leave the ports set as they are, and that will make sure that all of the MIDI ins and outs are active and ready to be used. There's one final thing. Let's go back to the studio menu and select audio connections. And this is really important. This is where we set up our inputs and our outputs. So you can see the two tabs along the top. My input is not connected, so I'm clicking on it and selecting the Steinberg UR22 Mark II, which is really easy because there's only two inputs on the front, so it's automatically selected. Exactly the same with the output. I select the Steinberg UR22 and my left and my right output channels are already instantly routed. So we're set up and we're ready to record and monitor what we're recording. If your interface has more inputs and outputs, you can load and save different presets for different configurations. Now that we've got our connection set up, let's click on the plus button in the track list to add an audio track. We're using a microphone, which is one channel. It's a mono signal, so we're plugging it into the left-hand side of the hardware and we're selecting mono. Give your channel a name, that's always important. Our interface has two input channels, so the next thing to do is tell Cubase which channel the microphone's plugged into. It's a two-channel interface, so we've got left and right, but our microphone is plugged into the left channel. Let's do a quick recap. We've selected our audio device. We've set up the audio connections for the inputs and the outputs. We've added a track, and we've selected the correct channel that we're recording on. When we record information from a keyboard, it's MIDI data. So to record MIDI data, we need to add a MIDI track. So we do that in the same way we added an audio track. Let's quickly give the track a name. MIDI is quite an old technology, and it works on 16 MIDI channels. So any MIDI track can receive and transmit on up to 16 channels. Over on the left-hand side in our routing, if we've got multiple MIDI devices connected, we can select which device we're going to play and record from. As you play your MIDI device, you should be able to see activity in the MIDI monitor in the bottom right-hand corner. You may not be able to hear any sound though, and that's because MIDI doesn't transmit sound. only information. So we need to route the output to either an external instrument, which will play the sound for us, or an internal software instrument. We can add an instrument track in the same way we added an audio MIDI track, or we can go over to VST racks and add an instrument there. I'm going to add a rack instrument, and I'm adding Hellion Sonic SE3, which is a famous Steinberg VST instrument which comes in all versions of Cubase. Hellion Sonic SE3 has 16 slots which we can assign MIDI tracks to, so we're adding a MIDI track which is instantly routed to the first channel, or the first slot, in Hellion Sonic SE3. We've got the first slot selected, so we can double click on a sound to load that sound into the first slot. And now if we go to our MIDI output for that channel, you'll see that it's routed to the first channel. There's another 15 slots that we can add sounds to, so let's go and add another 15 MIDI channels. The channel that we created before was called Hellion Sonic SE01, so I'm going to call this Hellion Sonic SE02, and that's for a very specific reason. When I hit add track, Cubase will automatically number each of these tracks from 1 to 16, which is really handy. Whichever track I have selected, my external keyboard will transmit on. So I can go over to Hellion Sonic SE4 and click on slot 4 and double click to add a new sound in there. Now if I go and select 4 on the track list and play my external keyboard, we've got sound. It's that easy. Hellion Sonic SE3 also comes with these quick controls, which we can use to edit different parameters. We can have an external MIDI device to control these VST quick controls. It's super easy. Go up to Studio, go back to Studio Setup, and now let's click on VST quick controls. There's 8 of them. Click on the first slot, tick the Learn box. All I have to do now is go to my external device, move the knob that I want to control the first VST slot, and the address will change to whichever encoder or fader or whatever it is I'm using to control these 8 VST quick controls. It's really quick, it's intuitive, and it's super easy. Once you're done, you can click apply if you want to go and make other changes, or just hit OK. I give it a quick test and you can see that that first encoder is moving the VST quick control. Now you're free to take your hands away from the mouse and the computer, and you can play a note and start manipulating the sound of that note. Now we can record the notes and the quick control changes, which is really quite cool. There's a really quick and intuitive MIDI learn function. Right mouse click on one of these VST quick controls and then move your external controller, and instantly that control will be routed to the VST quick control. Thanks for taking the time to stop by and check out this video. There's plenty more in the video series. Please like the video if you've learned something and subscribe to our channel for plenty more videos like this. I'm gonna see you in the next video. Catch you then. And I don't feel anything without your love. I won't fight.